Thank you. spent as a Dodger. His career accolades include 10 All-Star appearances, 4 Gold Glove Awards, the 1974 National League MVP, and in 1931, he would become a world champion. He was a model of consistency. In fact, the majority of his Dodger career was spent as the anchor at first base for the most enduring infield in baseball history. The same position that hockey played. This is the kind of story that you refer to as a legend, and that is totally appropriate. And today, we are inducting this child of destiny, a legend of Dodger baseball. Congratulations, Steve Garvey.
Fellow infielders and your family. I'd like to be a member of your family. Your daughters have all refused to marry me. You've refused to adopt me. I feel like I've struck out on every count. But I just want to say, on behalf of all the fans who are now so excited to have these tiny bobblehead versions of you in our homes, congratulations. This is a great honor, a great achievement, very well deserved. And now, it's time to do it. Two Dr. Greats are going to unveil your Legends of the Dodgers plaque, and you will be enshrined forever here in this baseball museum. Congratulations, Stephen Patrick Garvey. A lifetime batting average of .294. In the postseason, a career average of .338. A quarter of the Fab Four that played in the Dodger infield with David Lopes, Bill Russell, and Ron Say for 8.5 years. A 10-time All-Star, most valuable player in 1974, who played in 1,207 consecutive games, which is still a National League record. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Garvey.
Humor.
numerous other opportunities for players to come.
As you can see, I was a blessed young boy. Be able to spend that first day looking up for Todd and Reese for
I learned from them.
It's not about the back of the room. It's about the front. Life has kind of stiff to us what we do with the parents who are here. Through all these years, there is one true constant that's been you, the band. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. And I want you to know that tonight, when you watch this game, you're watching this generation of excellence in baseball. Both teams will go out and they will play their best game tonight. But these men are the authors and poets of this great game. In real time, doing the most difficult of tasks, they will perform for you. Push them, applaud them, ask them to get more. And to do the single most difficult things is to play baseball. Use your patience. One final thought. Back in 1980, my teammates will remember, we were 3 games down to 3 games to go. Each one of those games, starting on Friday night, those who remember and may have read about it, stood from the second inning on, were the wind beneath our feet. Each night, we won in the eighth or ninth inning. That Sunday, I stood with Frank Clare, a great publicist for the